Hello everyone, welcome to part 25 of SQL for Beginner series. In this video session, I am going to explain and practically demonstrate trim MySQL function. So how to use trim MySQL string category function. Trim is one of the MySQL functions. There are several MySQL inbuilt functions are there, and trim function is one of them, and it falls under the string category functions. Let me show you what exactly this means. There are several built-in functions in MySQL which can be categorized at a high level into string functions, numeric functions, date and time functions, and aggregate functions. When I expand the string functions, there are several string category functions here, and trim function is one of these string category functions type. This is what I meant there. Now, what is the purpose? What is the purpose of using trim function? What is the purpose of using trim function? The purpose of using trim function is to remove the leading and trailing spaces in the column data. What does this mean? To remove the leading and trailing spaces in the column data. For example, there is a table and it has a column. Let's say there is only one column here. Let's say the column name is some full name column, and there are some records in this table. Like this, there are two records, and the record data is something like this. Here, Arun Motori is there, that's fine. Okay. The second data, some spaces are there. Space 1, space 2, space 3, and then some Varun space. Okay. And last name, space, space, say, space. Like this, some spaces are there. Here, there are some three spaces before this Varun, and there are some three spaces after last name. So this, in case of Arun Motori, before there are no spaces, and after also there are no spaces. But coming to the second text, under this second record text under the full name, it has some spaces before and after. If I use trim function here, if I use trim function with this kind of full name, okay, if I use string function with full name, trim of full name. If I use trim of full name, then for the first record, there is no difference there because there is no space before Arun and there is no space after Arun Motori, right? There are no leading and trailing spaces in case of first record. So as it is, Arun Motori will come. But when the second record is processed, it has some spaces before Varun and after Kovala, right? Before and after, this is leading space and this is trailing space. So when you apply this trim function, this will remove the spaces, blank spaces before the text and after the text. So the result will be, without spaces, it will return you the text under the full name. Okay, the spaces before and after will be removed by this trim function. That is the purpose of trim function, guys. So let me practically demonstrate how to use trim function with different examples. So fine. Now, if I say select Arun, okay, if I say select Arun, what will be displayed, guys? Arun will be displayed, that's fine. Now, if I say length of Arun, what will be displayed? If I say select length of Arun, what will be displayed? Instead of Arun, the length of Arun will be displayed. What is the length? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 will be displayed. What if I add some spaces here? 1, 2, 3 spaces before Arun and 1, 2, 3 spaces after Arun. You see the length got increased from 4 to 4 plus 3 plus 3. 4 plus 3 plus 3 is 10. So with spaces it is calculating, right? Now what if I remove this length and use trim here? Okay. Select trim off with spaces Arun, and on the top of this, if I use length, okay, like this. So it has two functions here. We are using two functions here. First, trim of Arun will happen. So what does trim will do? It will remove the spaces before Arun and after Arun. There are three spaces before Arun. Those will be removed by the trim function. And there are some three spaces after Arun. Those also will be removed by the trim function. So remaining is Arun. What will be the length of Arun? Only 4. Okay. Without using trim, you will get 10. But when I use trim and then calculate the length, you will get only 4. Run it. You see only 4. That means the spaces before Arun and after Arun got removed. This is how the trim function works, guys. Okay. So what if I have to apply with the same thing with the columns? Okay. This without column data from the tables, I have explained you or demonstrated you how to use a trim function. Now I would like to apply this to the one of the columns in the table data. Okay. One of the columns in the table. Let's say I'll assume the sample statement like select star from customers. Select star from customers. So all the table data, that is 91 records and all the columns from the customer table will be displayed, right? Complete data got displayed. That's fine. Now, so here 91 records are there, but all this data, which is default available in this particular table, doesn't have any spaces before and after. If you see, if I try to calculate the space, I mean, if I try to calculate the length of this particular text, customer name text, if I say customer name, select customer name, or select customer name from customers, okay, if I say length, and here also again, if I say customer name, comma, okay, customer name, comma, length of customer name from customers, if I say something like this, this customer, what is the length? It will be displayed on the right side, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. That means there are no spaces before and after this customer name. Like that, all the records are same, guys. The default included records in this particular customer table doesn't have any spaces before and after. So I cannot show you, right, how the trim function works with the columns, right? I cannot show you how the trim function works with these columns. So what I will do is I will insert a. So what we can do here is we can say select star from customers, run it. So how many rows are coming? Records are coming, 91 records, total 91 records. I'll try to insert a new record. Okay. Originally, all the records in this table doesn't have any spaces for any of these columns. Here, all this, whatever the data you take here, there doesn't have any spaces before and after. So I cannot demonstrate how to use trim with the columns, right? So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to insert a new record into this particular table. So far, in the previous videos, I have never done this. Okay. And how to do that? There is a statement like in SQL, if you have to insert some data into the or some records, new records into this table, existing table, we have to use insert command. Insert into. Okay. Insert into. Don't worry, guys. This statement I'll explain in detail in the upcoming videos. But since there is a need for us where I have to manually create a record, because default records doesn't have any spaces for any of their column data. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to insert the data myself. Okay. Instead of default records, I'm trying to insert some extra record. That is 92nd record I want to insert. How to insert all those things? What are the things that are required for inserting? Everything I will be explaining in the upcoming videos, guys. Okay. For now, blindly follow this. Insert into is a statement which table name we have to give. Table name is customers. Okay. This is a customers table. Insert into table name values. Okay. You have to say values. Insert into table name values. Then you have to give the all the values. So let's say this is the 92nd record. Okay. First name is customer ID is 92, comma. Customer name is, let's say, Arun Moduri. Here I'm trying to add spaces, guys. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This is what I need. This is what I need. Now, third thing is contact name. I'll say C name. Just giving some dummy data, guys, because I only will work on this particular column. Okay. C name, C address. CCT. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 I'm giving as a dummy postal code, and C country. Close this and put a semicolon. All the column data I have given here, right? Insert into table name with values, all the values you have to give. This is the syntax for inserting the new data into the existing table. So I will explain more about how to insert in a detailed manner in the upcoming videos. For now, I hope you understood at a high level. So when I run this, this particular customer name with some spaces before and after. So originally, what is the length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 is the length. But here I am adding 3 spaces before and after. So 12 plus 3 plus 3. How much? 12 plus 3 plus 3 is 12 plus 3 is 15. 15 plus 3 is 18. So total is 18. Right? Size will be 18. So let's see. Let's say include this record. Insert this record. Now a record got inserted. When I say select star from customers, run this. Now you will get 92 records. And this particular text looks like there are no spaces before and after. In order to confirm whether there are some spaces before this Arun and after Arun text, what we can do is we can say select customer name, comma, length of customer name. Length of customer name from customers where customer ID is equal to 92. When I run this, the last customer table will come. You see, customer name is Arun Motori and here length is 18. But here when you calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, only 12 is there. But before spaces are 6, 3 spaces before and 3 spaces after. So total 12 plus 3 plus 3 is 18. That's why we are getting 18. Now, if you want to remove the spaces and then calculate the length, what do you have to do? You have to say trim. Trim of customer name. This is how we have to use trim function with the columns. Okay. Column names from the tables. Select customer name, comma, length of trim of customer name. First trim function will act on the customer name. So all the spaces before and after will be removed from this. And only the text that is available after spaces will be calculated for the length. So only 12 will be calculated. This time you see, you'll get the result as 12. This is how, guys, we have to use trim function. Okay. So that's fine. Now let's go back. Select star from customers. Run it. Now I am getting 92 records, guys. But by default, whatever the w3schools.com guys have provided in the customer table, there were only 91 records. Since I have inserted some 91, one extra record, it became 92. But I want to restore the previous data. Whatever the modification I have done to this particular table by including a new record to the existing 91 records, I added a new record. This is a modification I done. But I want to restore the data. Okay. I want to go back to the original data that is being provided by the w3schools.com where my extra record is not there. So in that case, what I can do is I can simply say restore data and click on OK. After doing that, again run this select star from customers. This time you got only 91 record. That means the data which is there in the customers table got restored to the original data that was given by the w3schools.com. So guys, tomorrow when you practice in this w3schools.com, okay, and you may be doing a lot of modifications for these tables. And if you want to go back to the original data provided by the w3schools.com and remove all your changes that you have done to the existing tables, simply use this restore data base button and you will get you the original data. You see, now only 91 records are coming. That's fine. So this is how, guys, we have to use trim MySQL string function. So one more thing, guys, we are done with the trim function, but are there any other functions left in string functions category of MySQL? Yes, guys. So here, so far from the previous videos, I explained only 7 functions under the string functions category of MySQL built-in functions. I explained in previous videos upper, lower function, length function, INSTR function, substr function, concat function, and in this video session, I covered trim function. So apart from the 7 functions, there are many more functions. Many more string functions. Anyhow, these are the most used functions. Okay. most use string functions in MySQL built-in functions categories. Fine. Apart from the string functions, there are many other functions provided by the MySQL under the string functions category. Let me show how to find out all the other remaining functions. Apart from this 7 functions, there are many more functions. How to find out? Just Google search, guys. Google search for MySQL. Okay, MySQL string functions. Simple. Okay, MySQL string functions. You'll get this kind of link: dev.mysql.com doc something and string hyphen functions. Just go there to this particular page. You see there are many more functions available. I explained only 7 functions out of this available functions. I only explained main functions, guys. Okay, if you want to refer other functions of string functions of MySQL, okay, then you can refer this page where you see ASCII function is there, some field function is there. You see I covered concat function and whatever the other functions I covered INSTR function, okay, I covered lower function, like that. So up to 7 functions I covered out of all the available functions in the string functions category of MySQL. But there are many other functions, so you can refer. If you need any function which is not explained by me, you can refer to this particular table and find out how to use it. Okay, so that's it, guys. This is all about the string category functions, and this is all about the how trim function of MySQL is going to work. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.